So what is this threat that I'm talking about that can undercut our entire faith? What happens a lot of times in other religions, let's not talk about Islam for a second. In other religions, when somebody gets into trouble, they grab on an amulet. They grab on a crucifix, or they grab on some kind of a charm, some kind of a thing. And they say, well, this thing protects me. This ring that I'm wearing protects me. This band that I have around my wrist, it protects me. This locket that I have protects me. Or this book that I've put in my dashboard protects me. You understand? Or if I go and I do sprinkle this kind of water on myself, that special water is going to protect me. There's physical things in other religions, physical things that people start attributing, they have supernatural protective powers. And if I have those things, then I'll be protected somehow. Now some of that made its way into even Muslim thinking. That we started believing in objects that have special powers. Which is why you find people go to Umrah and they go to Hajj and they sneak in a pair of scissors. And when they get to the Kaaba, they'll cut out a little bit of the cloth and bring it home. And every time they get, sinus infection, rub it on their forehead because it's going to get rid of all their problems. Now they're believing that because this cloth was touching the Kaaba, that somehow this cloth has supernatural powers and it's going to heal them. The thing is, now you're looking at protection from things. And you're starting to lose your connection from the idea that Allah Himself is the one who protects. And sometimes this idea, instead of bringing, and people do this thinking that they're doing something religious, but actually this is taking you away from the religion. This is taking you away from Inna Waliyyi Allah. My only protector, the one next to me, is in fact Allah. Then a lot of times people start believing in, harm that can come to them from the unseen, and there's an obsessive, compulsive tendency among many Muslims, sometimes educated Muslims, well-learned Muslims, to believe if something is wrong with me, if I lost my job, if I'm going through depression, if I'm having trouble in my marriage, if I got diagnosed with a disease, if this happened, this problem happened, that problem, somebody did magic to me. I need to find out who did magic to me. And if they did magic, I need to find, if they did some spell, I need to go to someone who's going to find me the prescription to undo that spell. And this happens in other religions all the time. But this kind of ignorant thinking has made its way into our religion, where people have started believing that they can go to certain people who will make them prescriptions, literally. Hey, I'm going to write this word on this piece of paper, you fold it up, and you swallow it, don't ask questions, or dip it into your orange juice and then drink it, let the ink go in, and then drink it, and that's it. You will find your lost motorcycle. It's going to come back to you. It's going to drive on its own. It's going to be on your driveway before you know it. My problems are going to be solved. Somebody magically stole my motorcycle, and it's magically going to come back because I'm following this prescription. And what's even crazier is a lot of times the people who make these kinds of prescriptions, they'll put ayat of the Quran. Words from Allah's words. And so the one who doesn't understand the purpose of the Quran thinks, well, it has Quran on it. It must have special powers. It has Allah's name on it. So this must be a good thing. Let me put this, and I've seen this in many people's homes. What we do is, to protect the house or something, on the fridge, you'll have like a piece of paper. It has Alif Lam Mim, Hamim, Yasin, Taha, the names of surahs that begin with the letters. There's a little, a chart with all those letters. And what's that there for? So the bananas don't expire quickly, right? So that the food will stay. This is going to make sure that this is preservative for your foods or protection for your house. Who came up with this? Let's take a step back for a moment. And by the way, the counter argument when you question something like that for you, and I'm not saying you go and start these fights at home. That's not what I'm saying. I want you to understand why this is problematic, not because it's ignorant or evil or wrong. I'm saying why is this problematic? It's taking you away from Allah. You're not realizing it's taking you away from Allah. That's the biggest harm. That's the biggest harm of all. The thing is, when you start believing in these kinds of prescriptions, there's a really deep problem in the way you think about your faith and the way you think and I think about Allah.